We're doing a little International Women's Day Q&A.
There's so much going on in the world right now, and there's so much even just in our busy lives that we're doing, mm-hmm. and I don't think it's sustainable, no matter how much we try, to just keep going, you know, go all the time. Yeah, that's not sustainable, so I think it's really important to have time to yourself or time with your loved ones to just breathe. Yeah. And just sit in everything you're feeling, you know, emotionally, physically, spiritually, all of it, and just let it all out.
It's really important, you know, that we stop and take a moment and do whatever it is, like you said, that helps fill your well up. Whether that's having a long bath and a glass of wine, or going to the movies, or again, hanging out with your loved ones. I feel like everyone says this, Oprah, etc. It's that whole thing of like, when you're in a positive mindset and a place of gratitude, you find more things to be grateful for and you attract more wonderful experiences into your life. When you're negative, it's very easy to get caught into a downward spiral, digging yourself into that hole. So I think it's everything, to be honest. And you know, that can be different for everyone. Like for me, I think sometimes people think I'm crazy, but I've got these affirmations set on my phone. So at 9, 12, 1, 3, 5, and 6 every day, they pop up as a reminder. So it's like, even if I'm in the middle of a really busy day, it's like, oh, that reminder to like have this moment, think about what I'm grateful for, and then continue with whatever it is that I'm doing.
That's brilliant. Of all the things that can hurt you in the world, you're up there on that list. Like a negative headspace and the way you treat yourself and the conversations you have mm-hmm. with yourself, they need to be positive, because so often they're not, and that can be influenced by so many different things. So.
Totally. My mum always says, it's the whole like, would you speak to your best friend or your lover or your parents the way you speak to yourself? Yeah. And the answer most often is no. You would never speak to someone else that way. Mm. So
exactly.
Yeah, exactly what you said.
Exactly.
Being kind to yourself.
I was, you know, it was really just when I started on the show and was very new to acting, and I was just wanting to do a good job. And it was really, I found it really difficult. I didn't know how to sort of deal with it mentally, seeing those sort of comments from people I didn't know. Just going, why are you saying that stuff? Why are you being so terrible?
You don't even know me.
Yeah, and some terrible transphobic stuff too, which was just, you know, took me back to these periods that I thought I'd long passed. Mm-hmm. So it was quite hard, and it comes up, you know, rather regularly with this show. So what I do is, for me, what works is talking about it with people, with my family and friends, because if I don't, if I sort of sit and dwell, I catastrophize, I just get more anxious, and it just gets bigger than it should be. So when I talk about it, it's easier.
Anyway, thank you so much for watching this little video.
And happy International Women's Day. And to all you women, trans women,
yes,
black women out there, in the whole spectrum of womanhood, we love you. This day is for you. Every day is for you.
Mwah. Chef's kiss. Mwah.